Hi everyone, welcome back to Prakashan Tutorials. In this video, I am going to discuss about quantization noise or quantization error in PCM system. Derive an expression for quantization noise or quantization error in a PCM system for linear quantization or uniform quantization. The use of quantization introduces an error, which is the difference between quantized signal to the sampled signal. This type of error is called the quantization noise or quantization error, and it is given by quantization error epsilon is equal to xq of nts minus x of nts. Here xq of nts is the quantized signal and x of nts is the sampled signal or input signal. The quantization error is the difference between quantized signal and input signal, that is xq of nts minus x of nts. Let us assume that the input x of nts to a linear quantizer has continuous amplitude. That continuous amplitude is in the range minus x maximum to plus x maximum. X of nts is an input signal to a linear quantizer. That input signal has continuous amplitude is in the range minus x maximum to plus x maximum. Therefore, the total amplitude range is maximum amplitude x maximum minus into minus x maximum minus into minus plus is equal to 2x maximum, and this is the total amplitude range. Now if this total amplitude range is divided into quantization levels, which is called as step size, so the step size delta is equal x maximum minus of minus x maximum divided by quantization levels, which is equal to 2x maximum divided by L, where x maximum is the maximum amplitude and L is the quantization level. Again, now if the input signal x of t is normalized to minimum and normalized to maximum values, which is equal to 1, then we have x maximum is equal to 1 and minus x maximum is equal to minus 1. Therefore, the step size is delta is equal. And what is the equation of the step size? This is the equation of the step size. Now here we are considering the signal x of t is normalized to minimum and normalized to maximum, and its value is equal to 1 and minus 1. And applying this condition to step size equation, we get the step size delta is equal to 2 by L. And this step size value is for normalized signal. The step size value is for normalized signal. Now, if the step size delta is considered as sufficiently small, then it may be assumed that the quantization error epsilon will be uniformly distributed random variable. The step size delta is considered as sufficiently small value, then it may be assumed that the quantization error epsilon will be uniformly distributed random variable. So we know that the maximum quantization error is given as epsilon maximum is equal plus or minus delta by 2. So this maximum quantization error value is already derived in the concept of working principle of quantization. Hence, over the interval minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2, the quantization error may be assumed as a uniformly distributed random variable. And this is the graphical representation of the uniform distributed random variable probability density function graphical representation. And the standard form representation is over the interval a comma b, the probability density function is given by or defined as fx of x is equal 1 by b minus a over the interval a to b, and x less than or equal to a, the value of the probability density function is 0, and x greater than b, the value of the probability density function is 0. So this is the standard expression of the probability density function of uniform random variable, and this is the standard graphical representation. So now here the quantization error is a random variable. If the step size is considered as a sufficiently small, then it may be considered as, it may be assumed that the quantization error epsilon will be uniformly distributed random variable and over the interval minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2. So now here we are considering uniformly distributed random variable over the interval minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2, and the width of this pulse is delta and amplitude is 1 by delta using this expression. The probability density function for a quantization error may be defined as epsilon of epsilon is equal 1 by delta over the interval minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2, and epsilon less than or equal to minus delta by 2, the probability density function value is 0, and epsilon greater than delta by 2, the probability density function value is 0. Ensure that the input signal should not exceed the quantizer. The input signal x of nts should not exceed the quantizer value, then with the mean value of the quantization error is 0 and its variance is same as the mean square value. So we know that the signal to quantization noise ratio of the quantizer is given by or defined as signal to noise ratio S by N is equal normalized signal power to normalized noise power. We know that the noise power is represented as noise power is equal V noise square by capital R. Here V noise square is the mean square value of the noise voltage. V noise square is the mean square value of the noise voltage. Since here the quantization error or the quantization noise is defined by the random variable epsilon and its probability density function is f of epsilon, therefore its mean value is given by mean square value is equal expectation of epsilon square. Epsilon is the quantization error. Now the quantization error is considered as a uniformly distributed random variable. So its mean square value is given by expectation of epsilon square is equal V suffix noise square. We know that capital X is the random variable. Capital X is the random variable. The mean square value of the random variable is given by expectation of X square is equal integral minus infinity to infinity X square into fx of x dx. And this is the standard expression of the expectation of x square or mean square value of the random variable x. Now here the random variable epsilon is the random variable. Similarly, the expectation of epsilon square is integral minus infinity to infinity epsilon square into f of epsilon d epsilon. Now here, what is f of epsilon? That is a probability density function. Probability density function. Here the probability density function is given by or defined as 1 by delta over the interval minus delta by 2 plus delta by 2. Now applying probability density function of the quantization error value in this equation, we get expectation of epsilon square is equal integral minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2 epsilon square into probability density function value is 1 by delta over this interval into d epsilon. 1 by delta is written before integration. Integral epsilon square d epsilon is epsilon q by 3 over minus delta by 2 to plus delta by 2. And now substitute upper value of epsilon and lower value of epsilon, and simplifying RHS term, finally we get the expectation of epsilon square value is delta square by 2. Substitute upper value of epsilon delta by 2 and lower value of epsilon minus delta by 2, and after that simplifying RHS term of this equation, we get expectation of epsilon square value is delta square by 12. Now the mean square value of noise voltage. So what is the mean square value of the noise voltage? Expectation of epsilon square is equal V noise square is the mean square value of the noise voltage. Now here what is expectation of epsilon square value? Delta square by 12. Therefore the mean square value of the noise voltage is delta square by 12. Also, if the load resistance is considered as 1 ohm, then the noise power is normalized as, and what is the basic expression of the normalized noise power? V noise square by capital R. Capital R is the resistance. So for the normalized case, the load resistance is considered as 1 ohm, and V noise square value is already calculated, and substitute V noise square value and the resistance R is equal to 1 value in this equation, we get the normalized power is equal to delta square by 12. Hence, finally, the normalized noise power or the quantization noise power or the quantization error in terms of the power is delta square by 2. And this is the concept of quantization noise or quantization error in PCM system.